Yes, I just learned that not everybody knows Leroy Merlin. Probably I pronounce it totally wrong. And Claire, she's from France, she will correct me with the correct pronunciation. This project was done in Brazil. It's a omni-channel in-store solution. We will explain a little better. But first, I think, Claire, you can explain a little about Leroy Merlin and what it is about.
Thank you, Willy. So I'm a customer, so I will be speaking like a customer. I'm from France. I've been to Brazil in 2012 to implement SAP. And as the project was going on, we decided to work with Ibris for an in-store project. So let me talk a little bit about first what is my company. So Leroy Merlin, in a good French accent, is a company worldwide present today in do-it-yourself, present in more than 12 countries, opening countries in Africa very soon. And it's part of a group, so I'm back now in the group working in the headquarters, which is called ADEO, where our specialty is to sell products, but also to send projects to the customer. Our main objective is to try to help the customer to build a real project and not only to come to the store to do a buying of a product, simply buying products, but we really try to improve the solution as a global project for own customer. As part of ADEO, there is not only Leroy Merlin brand, there is also other brands. So talking about Spain, for example, we have Aki, we have Bricoman, we have also in Italia and in France a company which is called Zodio. And all of those companies are really related to the do-it-yourself company as a retailer. Today, if you go in a Leroy Merlin store, there is more or less 80,000 products. In the store. What you have to say on an IT point of view that when we do migration, let's say, that we have to deal with more than 1,050 products. So it's really, in terms of volume and management of all of this, it's quite heavy. We also divided in 15 categories, which is, on a business point of view, much more oriented ADEO point of view than customer point of view. We will see with the Ibris project and with our omni-channel project how we switch to a company category point of view to a business customer-oriented categories.
Yes. Okay. Okay, let's start a little in the past. We have a we are talking about omni-channel. So in the past, we were talking about a single channel. You go to a store, that's it. Then Leroy Merlin already, they have a lot of channels. You can see the multi-channel concept. And when we started talking with them, it was about starting a digital transformation of how to integrate all these channels one with the other. So real experience about omni-channel for the customer. So there were some challenges they faced, and they need to attack these challenges. One of the challenges is that customers are moving more and more to the B2C channel. They are not going so much to the store. If you think about city, Sao Paulo is big, so it's easier to just buy online. Another thing is how to attract new customers, young customers. Customers that are used to work in all the channels or to buy in all the channels. A digital strategy. We need to find a strategy that was a moment we did at the beginning, was really hard. We are not here just to tell about beautiful things. It's difficult to implement this. And there were a long time, a strong moment at the beginning where we planned together with Leroy how to do this project, how to start this strategy. There was SAP implementation in parallel, so you can imagine this is not easy to do. Another thing is how to adapt the sales structure. If you have an in-store solution, you start using hybrids inside the stores, you need to think about how you can integrate your collaborators, how you train them, and all this stuff that comes with that. Then the B2C channel. Of course, it's the first thing you want to integrate in the omni-channel solution, and to not have, let's say, some difficult situations in between the B2C and the in-store, they need to work together. You need to figure out a way how they can complete each other. And in the end, yeah, you try to mixture the physical and the virtual situation. You try to get out the best of both. So you need to join it. Yeah, okay, when we are talking now about guided sellings and assisted shopping, we put these both words to show you one of the main things that Leroy was thinking since the beginning. It's not just about how the customer sees the omnichannel and the in-store solution inside Leroy, it's also how the collaborator, the sales guy, the sales force on the floor, how they see it, because they need to work with the hybrid solution in the end also. So there are like three concepts we need to take care of. The first thing we have is the guided selling. In the B2C channel or the B2B channel, you have guided selling like a search, you have filters, you have product description, attributes, and so on. This is something that guides you. And in the store, you have the sales force. This is an experienced guy that do this a long time. He knows everything about the products. So you need to find now a way to merge both. Another concept is about user experience. I mentioned this. It's not only about how the customer sees this, it's also how the sales force see this tool. So from the beginning, a key point in this project was the user experience for both sides. And then, yes, the omnichannel is you need to merge, you need to marry both. And to complete it, to create a real omni-channel experience. And of course, you need to improve. Once you have done the go live, you need to invest. That's why there was, since the beginning, a discussion about the plan, how to improve the solution. OK, now, before I give back to Claire, what we faced, or what were the difficulties that we had at the beginning? So if you think about a scenario without a guided selling, without this help. So you come to the store, and the first thing that a difficulty you face is you don't find the products. So this is something you need help, for sure. If I come to a department store, I don't know where to go, and I'm really lost. So I'm the perfect customer. Another thing is stock. You just can find what is in the store. But if it's not in the store, you have no idea how to get this product. Maybe you can, maybe not. And another thing is a question about knowledge. How you know details about the product? I have no idea about colors and paintings and stuff. So I go there, I read the box, that's all I know. So this is something where omnichannel really can help. So let's see now how Leroy did this.
So we are going to talk about two aspects within this guided selling process. First one, as an objective to be omnichannel, as a normal objective, the customer needs to be in the center of all our process. So let's talk about what are the benefits with this project that we need to and we try to reach implementing Hybris with all of those components. First, the product recommendation was really for the customer when he's at home. For sure, we try to and we manage to have the same front and the same approach on the product and also complementary information of the product like videos, like comments of other customers, books of the suppliers that he can give it to you. And this, we manage to give this to the customer. Thanks to this implementation, that's something that was not so easy before. The only thing, the other thing also that we managed to implement was the cross-selling based on the real-time stock of the store, of all of the stores of the area. Remember that in Brazil, it's the size of the Europe. For sure, when you are in São Paulo and you want to go in the north of Brazil, there is a timeline difference. There is a logistic point of view difference. Thanks to fiscal in Brazil, also, you are not going to pay the same tax, which also makes our life as a company a little bit more complicated. There is also a personalized, when we are talking about personalized service, fast purchase with agile and efficient system is really on how the user experience process happened during the project. The mobility first, the approach to design that the process will be easily understandable by the customer was one of the key points of this project. And at the end, we managed to have the physical and digital work together, and that's also something that we will reach after with the collaborators gains that we have made. But there is one point that we wanted to put the customer in the center of our strategy, but as a store is historically the main things for Leroy Merlin, because we started with store and we not started with the digital environment. We wanted as 80% more or less as a normal percentage goes to the web before going to the store. We wanted to make the customer really good and have a real link between what he has made on internet and when he reaches to the store, he will find the same screen, the same categories. When I said that we used to have 15 categories on a company point of view, we reorganized this, that when the customer was coming to the store, we were not talking anymore with him and the collaborators about the company departments, but yes, a customer departments. Talking about the benefits from the sales teams, One really goal that we had is that nowadays the collaborators at home, they do have, everybody's got smartphone. The Brazilian also are really kind of all of those social network, Facebook, WhatsApp is everyday life, every minute life in Brazil also. And the thing is that we offered before this new project really solution that were not up to date, let's say, to the real life. So the attraction of the collaborators to him to be good at work, to feel also that he doesn't have a better quality in his own life of application, but also at work he can reach this level of application, this level of user experience when he goes to Facebook, and then he had to, before this project, make a customer order within our solution. You had to have several days of trainings, make sure that you do the F1 function correctly. That was really not user-friendly. So the in-store mobile solution, the access to the contents, the access to the product was really made like as our collaborators is a customer, is here to help the customer, so he is sharing the same information in a way that he can understand really easily. Okay, just to give you, for example, an example, all of the training that we have done before implementing the solution was a training made on gamification. So yes, we did go to a classroom to explain them how to use, but as they were, and it was a need before entering to this gamification, to use already since was 1 year our website, our Leroy Merlin website in Brazil, so that when they enter the classroom, really the change and the training via the gamification process was really in half a day, all of the sales people were trained. So this is really a trend. And in the rollout that we are going to do, our objective is even to go, not to go in a classroom with really someone from the project who is going to train, but to try to do this in every store, 2 hours, via gamification, and just one person in the store that is expert, but is not even part of the full classroom. So we are going to test this, but according to what we have seen for the first stores, we really think that it's going to take easily. Few other things about the sales team. One new thing that also this new platform gave it to us is that in Leroy Merlin Brazil, lots of customers were already using the phone to call to make an order. coming to the store or not. Usually it's partners that are in the customer house and wants to buy because they are there to build a new kitchen, and they see that they are missing something. So they are calling Leroy Merlin without going to the store. Before this project, what happened is that within the call center, the Leroy Merlin collaborators did have to open one application for every store. And when the customer had placed one order in one store, he had to open the other application. So that was really not user-friendly. And at least for the customer, it was also really long because he had to wait. The application happened, switch. So really the process was not really between all channels. So now with the first go live that we have made, when the customer is calling, and if he's coming back 2 days later in a store to make another orders, yes, the collaborators will see, as they are sharing the same platform, that the customer had placed an order in his store or maybe in another store. So that was really a big change. The other change is that the inventory was also centralized, and from whatever store you are, you will see the inventory of your store, but also of the region where you are, and if needed, from Brazil, if the customers got a house in Rio or I don't know where, this is a new opportunity without opening another application to get this store. This was really linked also to the implementation, as we said, of SAP. When we started the project of the store project, we said implementation SAP, we decided to switch all of the application of the store. So we changed POS, we changed guided sell, and we changed all of the management of the back office. So implementation of for the SAP knowledge of CAR permits that from Ibris we retrieve all of those stocks, and no matter where the store was, we could reach real time between the supply activities and the customer activities from the POS, with buying and buying product without knowing from where it took those product, to update this inventory. To talk about the project and to go a little bit further, the guided sell is not something new in Leroy Merlin. That's something that exists almost since the beginning. Of course, so when we started and we decided to implement with FH this guided sell, we already had some idea on how our business is working. And we also, knowing the market, Leroy Merlin also is looking what is happening in Europe, what is happening in the US or even in Asia. So for sure, the global digital transformation strategy is something also that Leroy Merlin and ADEO is going on. So we really took this project to decide to innovate on this implementation. On this point of view, there is one thing that we I'd like to share is that to start this project, because also we implemented SAP, first module of SAP, which took a little bit longer than we saw at the beginning for the first module. What we learned is that when we started the project, the business was here as the main people to explain to the integrator what they want, how they want their future and everything. But it was, let's say, open. So there was no really control on ask what they want and we will see what we can do. And then that's one reason also why it took a few months more than it was planned, because the business know what happens today, thinks that they know where they want to go, and our partner is trying to understand what they can do today, what they can do tomorrow, and see exactly. So when the problem is that when you do it like this, this project change a lot of business process before changing application for the collaborators or even the customer. So when we launched the project, we spent 3 months We organize with the POS supplier, the POS partner that implemented. We organize with the FIH as a partner for guided cell. We organize with also the partner who help us to implement SAP, a BBP, where everyone has a BBP, but we also had a business blueprint, explanation of what our business wants on a really transversal point of view. This transversal point of view, yes, we lost 1 month because it took time to make sure that supply really agrees that they want to go this way, that marketing really wants to go that way, that finance also wants to see this number in this way, that the salespeople wants to see their benefits in this way. But this month that we lose really meant really during the project, that really time that we didn't lose to discuss over and over, because we find out one more case that we forgot, one more case that we need to change within the store the process before putting the application. So that was really, at the end, again, that was hard at the beginning because you lose 1 month, so you have to explain to your director why you just want to lose 1 month, because you have to explain to them that they are not really sure of what they want to do in terms of business. It's not so easy to say on an IT point of view. But as we already suffer this from the first module implementation, we managed not to start, and we get trusted by our directors. And really, this really worked, because the implementation of the first store was made in the time that we didn't I think was 1 week delay. So let's say that 1 week delay in a little bit more than 16 months project is something that we would all sign, I think, if you start a project. The strategy has a whole, so that's this workshop, dedicated, transversal. Then every, let's say, part of the project was doing the realization. So yes, with Ibris and with FH, we started to make the project agile, in an agile method during all of the realization process. For sure, the post supplier was not agile. He was doing as a normal project, but we manage. We manage because there was plans, there was flexibility with the definitions that we have made, with the implementation. We had some key point where we had to meet, but really managed to make this hybrid project in an agile point of view. And then we meet at the end. We manage 3 months of integrated tests. So that was a big store within the headquarters of Leroy Merlin Brésil, where we made all of the plans.
Yes. From our side, I think there's no time to enter all the points. A lot of points are standard. But doing Hybris 10 years, what really impressed me was the dedication of the key user team. So since the blueprint, they onboarded, for example, sales guys that are doing this all their life. They know everything, and they were involved inside the strategy. They also onboard Hybris experts, Java experts. It's not always easy, I confess. There are a lot of good fights, let's say, but in the end, you are talking the same language. So it helped us to keep on track and to deliver the project on time. So for me, the key user dedication was really key. Not just IT, again, also business, not too much business, then you also never deliver, but it was a good mixture, and for us, this was really key at this project.
No? That one. Here it's just to make a summary of really the challenge of the project that we faced. First, we had a complex scope of customization. Let's remember that we used Ibris at the beginning not to install an e-commerce platform. We used Ibris to give this solution to collaborators in the store. So, for example, in Brazil, you negotiate a lot. Every time you buy something, if you pay cash, you say, I can have a few discounts. So in that case, we can share some nice discussion we had. In Ibris, there was really a customization, and the good the good thing and the good point of this was to find the way to do this customization with less cost now and for the future also. We need to make sure that we are able to maintain all of this. But the way to do this in the store made that this customization was really in a high level on a Hybris point of view. The thing also is that in South America, that was the first time when we were talking with the Hybris team that we had the implementation of the guided selling project. Okay, we had one customer in China that we heard that we made with another partner the guided sales, but with the expert we had, that was really the first one in South America. Then the deadline, as I said a little bit earlier, we already started a SAP project. We already had one delay, so one delay is good, but we could not have several delays much more accepted by the directors. So we really had deadlines, really strict, to make sure that the project was entering for the first store. And also, no delay accepting, also according to all of the several partners that were part, the cost, the development windows, according also to the Leroy Merlin Brazil, what we call the Festa de Bricolage and Caisson promotion that is happening during the year, made really a strict deadline on what we had to do. What something I already said is that really several integration. We had a nice picture on the wall with all of the integration in a guided sales, in POS, and that was really a big challenge to make sure that all of these things are talking together at the end. The usability also, that was the first time within the Leroy Merlin context that we really had an approach since the business blueprint where the UX guy was there on Leroy Merlin side to design everything that was the business was seeing in an application point of view. Okay, because that's something also that the business is facing much more than often, that they talk, they think of something in their heads, and it's only when you show to them that they say, no, finally, it's not really like this that I want, it's not really what I said, or I don't know what. So the mobile first, also to make sure that in a small mobile, we already see what he will give to the collaborators, and then after, to show to the business exactly what they ask is will give this for them when they will be in the store with the customer over here. What were the benefits of the project? You have a big list here. If I have to take one, I think the real-time inventory of all stores was really something that helped us to implement and to gain credibility on the customer point of view, but also collaborators' point of view. Okay, the usability. We had a nice video that was made 1 month ago after the implementation, where you have one collaborator that made a customer order in the new guided sales that we have made. It took six minutes and 30 seconds. With the other solution, it took more than 1 hour. It was 1 hour, 2 minutes, and 15 seconds. And the main reason, okay, you can say we did this just because we want to market and say that we really manage to make what we promise. But the main reason was no more copy-paste. The customer, you can show to your customer directly what you want. You don't have to look in two or three different applications to find the stocks, to find the way, the logistical point of where is the product. You don't have to look in several. You don't have to check physically. So we gain the trust on the collaborator managing managing the stock in this way. Okay?
Yes.
Bon, here yeah. it's more. You want
yes, maybe I can make a comment here because something. No. You can back to the next slide. It's
going to
explain some thing that really fascinates me with this project. If when you come to a store to Leroy Merlin, I am the guy that would do that start the process of buying something online. I need to be informed, so I enter there in their B2C channel. I list all the products I want, and then I have them in my cart. The next step for me is to go to the store because I have some doubts. And there's something really nice in this project. You can see in this payment gateway integration. It's possible with this solution inside the store, coming with my B2C card, I can negotiate with the collaborator in the store. So I'm not happy with my price. So Leroy gives me as a customer the possibility to start a little negotiation with them. So this guy in front of me, he can show me promotions. He can give me a little discount on some categories. Was really not easy to implement, as you can see in this landscape, but at the end, we could do it. And then when I finished, I have a deal, I want to buy it, then I can do the checkout directly with the guy in front of me, giving my credit card. He can do it with me and deliver everything home. I don't need to take care of everything. Or I go to a terminal, I do my checkout alone. Or he gives me like a command, like a ticket, and I go to the cashier and I pay there. So it's a real omni-channel experience that you can now discover inside the Leroy store. It's really fascinating. And as you can see, wasn't so easy to integrate this.
Well, this slide also, we are not going into details of everything, and depending on where you are in the store or in e-commerce or in the call center. But here it's really to show you that doing this project first in a store point of view really made that we had to implement much more things like negotiation, authorization also, because for sure a manager doesn't have the same right as a sole person. So everything had to be managed within the project. Will you talk a little bit about the Leroy team and FH team? On a Leroy point of view, we were really 50-50. 50 people from the stores, 50% people from the IT. Who was talking during the BBP? Who was making the test? Was people from the store. The business analyst, yes, I had some business analysts in my team to help the people from the store to explain exactly what they want, to ask a question because they already know what happened, so to make sure that they do not forget things. But who writes the test? Who made the test was people from the store. And I really think that this makes the difference, because when we have to go to the store, when you have to go to the director, when you have to go, and that's someone who was in the store to sell the product and say, oh, it's going to be great, I will like it, that makes the difference. It's not IT who is speaking, but really the business team who is talking. We had a joke also saying that they are not business anymore, they are now IT. So that was a joke that was coming really often. But really, even now, when the business ask evolution, they understand a little bit more about IT, and they also it's also really a gain because they don't ask. Sometimes yes, but it also managed not to ask a crazy thing because they know the integration, they know how the nightmare to do all of this, and it gives them a sensibility for the project, but also for the future of the project. Yes. On FH point of view?
Yes. On our team, maybe as a suggestion to everybody, it's of course, there is the project manager taking care of the scope. It's really important to avoid delays and to have a good payment on this project. There are always surprises. Architect, we couldn't manage with just one architect. We needed to add, there was a moment like three architects in the same project. This was really key and important because these guys are experienced. They find the best solution and they were really aligned with the architect from Leroy. The business analyst, here the key point is that this guy needs to understand the business, not just the IT part, also the business, to guide the team. So please take care of this. Developers here is only one word, but in reality, we had a moment with more than 20 developers in this project to attend all the demands. There were some surprises, some changes during the project, and we had a limited scope. So to deliver this, we need to add more people. And developers, it starts with a specialist for front-end development, a specialist for Solr, a specialist for the back development, for master data, and so on. So you cannot just onboard a Java guy. You need to have your specialist to react fast. And interface developers, I think everybody knows this. You have seen the landscape. There are a lot of integrations. If you do not have guys that dominate this, you will fail on the project. Hybris is difficult to implement. There is a situation you can spend 1 hour with an experienced guy, and there, a not experienced guy would spend like 2 weeks on the same thing. So always try to find specialists and people that have real experience. If not, you suffer.
Then to talk about really our partner FH that made the project with us. There are really three reasons why we worked in Brazil with FH. The first one was really, as I said, we were doing a global project with SAP implementation. In South America, that was the first time we entered with Hybris the guided cell. Hybris also was not a lot implemented in South America, and FH in South America and had knowledge from a few projects in Germany made the difference, because when we were talking about our needs to implement SAP and Hybris together, help us to really design the architecture and also make some choices according to what we wanted to do. The second one was really the commitment that we managed to see with few customer references when we made the RFP. We went through a process with RFP where several three actors were in the challenge, and really the customer reference gives us this commitment point of view. It really happens, a project that is going well. We know that also it's only on the paper, and we still have some, we discover things along the project. So we had some difficulties on both sides, customer, but also on partner side. But the commitments to respect the date really happens along the project. It has to be fair on both sides, let's say. And the last one was really competitive on a customer point of view, but also on the commitment to understand what is our business. Okay, the guided sale is different. It's not only e-commerce, but it's also a need to be on in the store to understand how we want the customer care within Leroy Merlin that made that the choice at the end between FH and the others that were in the project. And we are still with the rollout working with FH.
Yes, I think a last message from our side, it's key that you team up. You need to partner with the customer as an implementer. If you cannot join the teams, and I think this is something we managed very, very well on both sides, as you can see here, we try to team up again. It's something really key. Team up and the project will do well.